Welcome to Columbia Catholic Ministry. Now, here's your weekly update from Father Dan O'Reilly.
When we profess the creed and say, "I believe in God," that was a statement taken for granted for many centuries. Nowadays, when you say, "I believe in God," there's many people who look to you as if you're a little strange, that how could a rational person believe in an almighty creator? Well, this question has been tossed about for centuries. One of the most famous collections of proofs of the existence of God comes to us from St. Thomas Aquinas. He famously wrote his five ways of knowing the existence of God. The first one could be called the argument from motion. Something that is moved has to be moved by something else. So God is the prime mover and the starter of all things. Now that proof might sound simplistic, but there's actually proofs in the area of physics which say that a universe which is expanding as ours is has to have had a beginning. That as long as any universal system is expanding, it must have had a starting point. So Thomas Aquinas's proof from motion is actually confirmed by modern physics. The second argument is an argument from causality, that if something is caused, it has to have been caused by something else. And you can't have an endless stream of causes unless you have a beginning. So there had to have been a first cause. That cause, Thomas Aquinas says, is God. Now, some people, again, try to deny that the universe has a beginning. Some people argue that the universe is eternal, so that no beginning, no end. Well, again, modern physics has come up with a number of arguments which help us to understand that it does not appear that the universe is eternal. For one thing, if the universe was eternal, in any system which is ongoing for a long period of time, something called entropy exists. Things begin to break down, things slow down, and more chaos ensues. Our universe does not appear to be showing signs of entropy. So most people say that, yes, that is evidence that the universe did have a beginning and that that first cause continues to cause all of the things and systems that we have in the universe. The third argument is an argument we could call the argument about contingency and necessity. St. Thomas says that if all things were contingent, anything that exists, at some point, everything would cease to exist, and the universe would no longer be. So St. Thomas argues that there has to be at least one being whose existence is necessary to hold all things in existence, and that necessary being is God. Taken another way, we could say, imagine you're doing a painting. Your painting could be a landscape, it could be a portrait, it could be a painting of anything. All of those things you put in the painting would be contingent. But if you don't have a canvas and don't have any paint, you have no painting. So you have to have something that's necessary. And St. Thomas says for the universe, that is God. The fourth argument is the argument we could call the argument from perfection. You could say, for example, that something is good or something is better, something is strong or something is stronger. St. Thomas says that if you're going to measure anything on some kind of a scale, there has to be one end of the scale, which is perfection. And St. Thomas says that is God. Some people might not be convinced of that sort of way of thinking in this day and age, but it's certainly a way of saying that if there is justice, truth, and beauty in the world, the ultimate is always going to be Almighty God. The final argument is what's known as the argument from design, and that's one which is pretty famous, the idea that we can look at the order of creation, look at the design of the universe. We can only imagine that some intelligent and benevolent creator was behind it. In fact, we know in the universe today of at least 20 constants, from the speed of light to the decomposition of carbon to the force of gravity, all of these things, were they any different, human life could not exist. That's become known among scientists as the anthropic principle, that it appears that the universe in which we live was specifically designed for the existence of human life. The secular world tries to tell us that there's some kind of a divide between faith and reason. But the five ways of Thomas Aquinas show that reason can help us better understand our faith and have every reason to trust in the presence of God.